One, there are wise theorists who say things like, spaceships don't come equipped with rearview mirrors, and the outcast outlasts those who refuse to hear us, and sometimes the hardest rocks are just gems who play pretend, and the hill they climb shows that you can't win if you ain't right within, and honestly, there can't be love and anxiety. Don't be a person so poor that all you have is money, because chances are if you heard my bars, you would probably love me. Chances are these are bars from the songs that love me, and something that always seems to stick is you can't be an activist when you're the protagonist of your own life story that you will put on this earth to live, so live it. And know there's no such thing as a life that's better than yours. This here is my story. I hope you see it's really not that different from yours, too. While many of you were sitting in the comfort of your well-decorated adolescent bedrooms, being read to stories about princes and princesses and dragons and mischief and whatever else is in the children's books my mother never had time or money to read, me and my siblings were in the back seat of a three-door hoopty, silent, listening attentively as my mother introduced us to the first sound of our own heartbeat, scratched and skipping. The first story I was ever told was played over the repetition of an 808. The bass quaked as the drums tried to escape a stereo that was too old to hold its glory, or the story told between living and lyric. It is hip-hop that taught me that I was living lyric. So while many of you were sitting in the comfort of your well-decorated adolescent bedrooms, being read to stories about mystical creatures from desolate places, I was learning that I was one. Raised in what was considered to be the trenches, white picket fences didn't exist, just redlining to fence in institutionally defenseless communities of color, overpopulated by single mothers in three-door hoopties, raising three kids alone as fathers wait in prison, envisioning a world where they are not always drowning in the feathers of a Jim Crow. The worst part is, this becomes the only story ever told, regurgitated in textbooks that lack the context to attest to the complex narratives that exist just beyond the schools. Who told us that learning could only happen in classrooms? History doesn't teach about the lesson plans happening in the back seats of three-door hoopties, or how the mystical creatures from desolate places learn to cope, how they turn red lines into baselines, bars into bars, how they turn living into lyric, and lyric gave life right back. The reciprocity of respiration. Hip-hop is breathing in shitty situations and exhaling possibilities. It is hearing the narratives told about your community and daring to say no. So while many of you were sitting in the comfort of your well-decorated adolescent bedrooms, being read to stories about fiction and fantasy, I was learning how to write my own humanity in a way that fit the tempo of my own heartbeat, scratched and skipping. The first story I was ever told was played over the repetition of an 808. I turned my pen into a sword and slayed the dragons in classrooms and books. I wrote hooks about poverty, but never about being poor. I poured myself into my words and watched them spill all over and everywhere. There are black and brown kids who don't want to be activists. They just want to be the protagonists for once. They want to assemble a script of their stories and watch themselves come back to life. Hip-hop is a reincarnation of self. It is taking everything that died in your community and trying to make something out of the ashes. It is taking what little you have and daring to call it magic or mysticism or real. Hip-hop is showing people that they are real, that they are an archive of living and loving and something other than mystical creatures from desolate places. It is silence in the back seat of a three-door hoopty, breathing in a living lyric that may sound a lot different from yours, but at least you got to hear it. At least you got to breathe. Thank you.